Hey everyone, welcome back. So in last video we have seen how we can handle different type of weight. So we have created one sample feature and we have created one step definition where I have written very raw type of code. So we did not maintain any page locators in separate class. We have written everything here. There is a reason behind this because I want to show you the recent upgrade that happened in WebDriver IO that will affect the way we are writing this await, multiple awaits. That I'll create, I'll explain that in the next video. But in this video today, we are going to see how we can have IntelliSense in our feature file. When I say IntelliSense, as of now, if you come to feature file and if you hover your mouse on your steps, it will not suggest you the step definition, related step definition for this. If you see here, it is not showing the step. And even if you press control key in your keyboard and click enter or click on this enter button, it will not take you to the step. So to find the steps, either you have to do from here, you need to copy this and do a global search from here, and it will suggest you the related steps. So one is feature and one is steps, or other way is you can go to this related steps and then find this manually. If your code is very large, it will be very tough to find this way. Normally, if you would have worked in Selenium with Cucumber, in your Eclipse IDE, when you hover your mouse here and then click it, it takes you to the step definition, which is as of now not working here. So let's see how we can implement that. Other improvement I see is when you write any random, some other steps for which we have did not implement any step definition. For example, I'll say some line, I'll say some random line. Now we know that we did not write any code for this, and I want that if I'm writing some lines or some feature which does not implement any step definition, I should get some warning here itself, which as of now it's not giving. So let's see how we can have those things in our Visual Studio code in this WebDriver IO project. So what we have to do in the root, this root project folder, we have to create one folder called .vs code. Create that folder. Inside this folder, you need to create one file, JSON file. Name will be settings.json. Settings.json. In this JSON file, you need to write some lines. So first things will be Cucumber autocomplete. It is auto suggesting me, but it might not suggest you. So you need to say autocomplete Cucumber autocomplete dot steps. And then in square bracket here, you need to define the path of step fold, step definition. So our step definition, where it is under test folder, under steps, any file with dot ts is our step. So we need to say in double quote, test folder, which is this test folder, then slash steps slash any file inside this folder with .ts extension. So for any file, it's a *.ts extension. Just save this file. Now come back to feature file again. Now if you hover your mouse here and press keyboard, see it is suggesting you the related step definition for this. And if you click here, it will take you to the related step definition. So now IntelliSense is working for this, but still if I am writing some now if I write some other lines, right, something random line, it will give you error, unable to find step definition for this, right? So this is finding, and this also it is working now that if I have not implemented any steps, it is giving me error. And you can add one more step here. So for that, you need to, that is Cucumber autocomplete, and it should be strict Gherkin completion. Make it true. This will make sure that all the steps you are writing here, feature steps you are writing, have corresponding step definition is defined. So just add this two line in your settings.json file under .vs code folder, and you will have all the intelligence that you need for this, right? Now it is showing me all the related stub definition. Not only for this, even for if you go to any other feature file, if you hover your mouse, see, it is showing you what is the steps related. One more improvement, what I see here, it's not actually a big change, but it's still good to have. If you go to our feature step definitions, not this one, maybe. Let's see if we have import here. Yeah, see, we have these kind of imports, right? And if you see here, I'm writing dot dot slash dot dot and then src. It is fine and it is working, but I don't want to have multiple dot dot, it doesn't look good. So my import should work in a way that my import should start with base folder, means from this base project, and from there I should be able to navigate it directly. So base folder, in the sense, I should directly be able to start my line of import from src and then go inside it. So if you want to change the way, so for now example, if I comment this line and if I retype it again, import base underscore URI, and if I say from, in double quote or single quote, if I say type, now it is, see, it is not suggesting me src directly. So for that you need to say dot dot slash, and then it will give me src folder. I want to change the way I do import here, right? I want to start my import from the root project folder. We'll go to tsconfig, and inside this compiler option itself, either after target or after ESW, anywhere inside compiler option itself, add base URL, and in a double quote just say dot, okay, base URL and say dot. Now come back to a step definition, right? Now again, if I say here src, let me remove this step. Mirror is going to, let me close this. Okay, that is fine. So now I'll say import and if you see now, it is importing from src config. For example, I'll remove this again, completely delete it, and if I hover, it is not able to find, right? So I'll just remove one I and type it again and space control space. Now it will auto suggest you. Now if you just select it, it will auto import again. But now this time dot dot is not there. Even for API calls, now if I remove these dot dots, still it will be able to find these steps, right? And similarly for these pages as well. So now our project structure base URL starts from the import, how we are writing is starting from the base folder, that is base folders. Now we don't have any dot dot here. Now let's see, wherever we have implemented this kind of dot dots, let's update that. So in app.env we don't have, in home we don't have, login by default it was there, but let's remove this as well. If you see here, remove this, then go to register, remove from here this import dot dot as well. It will start from the src, and just to make sure it's working fine or not, press control and hover your mouse here. It should show you the suggestion for that page. It should resolve it in wait excel. So okay, we don't have any import here, so we don't need to. So yeah, these are the small changes that we need to do. It's not very effective, like it's not very big change, and the autos, you know, intelligence in our feature file will make your life little easy, because it will be easy to find your steps rather than going and manually searching. You can just directly navigate from here. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you so much.